The lawyers for the Rust Armorer, 24-year-old Hannah Gutierrez Reed, that's her full name, have a new theory to explain how a gun that she was in charge of ended up with a live round.
There was a box of dummy rounds, and the box is labeled dummy. She loaded rounds from that box into the handgun, only later to find out there is a, and she had no idea, she inspected the rounds, that there was a live round. Now, we're assuming somebody put the live round in that box, which if you think about that, the person who put the live round in the box of dummy rounds had to have the purpose of sabotaging this set.
They don't know that any of that happened, by the way. They don't have any evidence of that. Okay, so what does it mean? We're going to talk about it with a crew member, because crew members are coming forward, and you're about to meet one of them, who wanted off of that set because of unsafe working conditions. Okay? Our guest was Rust's camera chief. He left the day before all this happened. His name is Lane Luper. Lane, thank you very much. Let me bounce a couple of tech questions off of you, and then we'll talk about your situation. First, do you buy the sabotage theory?
No. And if they have any evidence of that, they should be, you know, talking to the sheriff and not morning television shows. It's dangerous and it's an irresponsible theory to put out on TV.
And you never heard anybody saying that they wanted to do something like that or have any inclination of why someone would try to do something like that?
No, absolutely not, okay. Chris. You know, a movie set's, it's a group of friends. You know, everybody there, you know, they deeply care for each other.
Right. Oh, look, I mean, you know, their job, if there's any litigation, is going to be to cast doubt. That's what they're doing
Of course.
They don't have to prove it, remember. But the idea that someone who's an armorer could load dummy bullets and actually be loading live rounds and not know it, even if they say they inspected the rounds, why that?
I mean, that would, in my opinion, that's sheer negligence. You know, it's not paying attention to what you're doing. You know, it's absolutely a responsibility of the armorer to make sure that you're, you know, properly loading the firearm and inspecting it before and after, and also not loading the firearm until right before you're going to shoot. You see, we actually have instructions for that. We have, you know, industry-wide safety bulletins that specifically spell this out.
Now, you left the job right before because of safety concerns. I want you to talk about it in the context of the response from the Rust producers, okay? Mr. Luper's allegations around budget and safety are false, patently. He had absolutely nothing to do with or knowledge of safety protocols or budgets. Safety is always the number one priority in our films, and it's truly awful to see some using this tragedy for personal gain. You make the case of why you had legit safety concerns.
Mm-hmm. Chris, to borrow a phrase from the producers, first of all, it's patently false that I'm not responsible for safety, because it's everybody's responsibility on set for safety. Everyone from the production assistants all the way up to the top producers. You know, so that's completely out the window in my book. As far as budgets and things like that go, that whole argument, it doesn't matter, because what happened was, is, you know, safety concerns were overlooked consistently, and it led to somebody dying on a movie set. You know, and that's the problem here, in my opinion.
Do you believe that your decision to, you know, to leave this set, had you ever done that before?
No, absolutely not. It's unheard of, and to be honest, you know, I'm terrified of my own repercussion. For them to say that this is for personal gain, it absolutely isn't. I don't want to be in front of cameras. My whole career is spent behind them.
What was your biggest concern that made you leave the job?
Well, it started out with all these red flags throughout the entire course of the production. It started with a lack of safety meetings. It started with inexperienced key personnel. You know, a lot of people being brought in from out of town. You know, it was one red flag after another red flag until finally, you know, there was the negligent discharges that happened on October 16th, where, you know, there were two firearm discharges that were not under anybody's control. And at that point, they should have stopped filming, pulled the firearm out of circulation per the industry-wide safety rules, but we kept filming anyway. And they never addressed it. And I addressed it with the producers themselves.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Look, Lane, I appreciate you coming forward and doing this and giving us some context on these allegations that have just come out and a feel for what was going on this set. Thank you. Lane Luper, I appreciate you.
Thank you so much, Chris. I really appreciate it.